conquer and disease. Details coming up also. The trial for ousted Sudan leader Omar al-Bashir and 27 co-defendants was postponed today until August 11th. And President Trump and Egypt's President al-Sisi agreed yesterday on the need to maintain ceasefire in Libya. All these and more ahead on African News Tonight. We start with our top story. UN agencies say a lack of money is threatening the lives of millions of people in developing countries from COVID-19-related hunger and disease. Lisa Schlein reports from Geneva.
The United Nations recently appealed for more than $10 billion to help hundreds of millions of people in the poorest, worst-hit countries in the world survive the COVID-19 pandemic. Nearly half the amount of the updated appeal is slated for food assistance, with an additional $500 million to be spent on famine prevention. However, the international response has been tepid since the UN launched its first of three global humanitarian response plans for COVID-19 in March, asking for $2 billion. To date, only $1.7 billion of the $10.3 billion needed has been received. The UN warns the number of hungry people caught in a state of crisis could increase from the current 149 million to 270 million before the end of the year without the international aid. Spokeswoman Elizabeth Beer says the agency's director David Beasley has warned the world runs the risk of a famine of biblical proportions.
Millions of the world's very poorest families have been forced even closer to the end. Livelihoods are being destroyed at an unprecedented level. Now, to prevent the worst, WHO